killing sticks. Premium carbon fiber arrows.
Hey now everybody, it's Jason Acorn here with the Boneyard, and welcome to season two.
Boneyard is brought to you by
Killing Sticks, premium carbon fiber arrows.
We're going to start the season off with one of my hunts. I headed south to Blairmore, Alberta, and hooked up with good friends Trevor and Ginger Garbiard. With hopes of bagging a mule deer of a lifetime.
Hey everybody, it's Acorn here with the Boneyard. I'm just about to leave Red Deer and head on down south to southern Alberta, Crow's Nest Pass, Blairmore, Pincher Creek area, to hopefully put a smack down on one of the biggest mule deers of my life, my career. So stay tuned, I'm going to bring you all along, and this is going to be one hell ride, I'll tell you. So stay tuned, the action's about to begin. It's September 14th and it's 28 degrees out, so I'm hoping that's not going to have an adverse effect on the mule deer hunting down south. The farther south I go, the hotter it gets. I just passed the district of Pincher Creek sign, and I just drove by a dead buck in the ditch, so I saw velvet on him, and I'm a crazy SOB when it comes to stuff like that, so I have to walk back and check it out and just show you one of the fatalities come across today.
I finally made it. Made it to Blairmore finally, and my lord, this place is unbelievably beautiful. I could have wasted so many cards stopping every 5 minutes to do some videotaping, because it's just like around every corner it was more beautiful than the next, so it's incredible. But this is where I'm going.
Timber and Tides.
And now I'm in mule deer heaven. So Trevor and I head out for an evening hunt. What seems to be the problem there, Trevor? What
the fuel.
I
touch that remote, the Boneyard will be right back. And so will I.
This segment is brought to you by
Cam Clark Ford, located on the west side of Gasoline Alley, Red Deer, Alberta.
We're back.
So it's our second morning. It's got to be below zero. What are we going to do this morning?
We're going to go kill one.
I think so. I think it's time.
It is time.
We got a field with some big bucks in it and hopefully some elk. So we're going to try to head them off and put the smack on something big. Here we go again.
So time.
Trevor and I are seeing a ton of deer, but they're either too young or we don't have permission. But finally, we have some shooter bucks in the right spot and the stock is on. People, I'm looking for a mature mule deer. But before we get to see if I take one of these majestic animals, we're gonna do the bonehead tip of the week. So on this week's tip, I'm gonna show you the do's and don'ts on how to properly use a self-climber tree stand. So the self-climber is just that. You climb the tree and it is super cool. What you have here is you have your upper section and you have your lower platform section. Now what you do is you take this cable and you wrap it around the tree. The tree's width is usually from 6 inches up to 20 inches depending on the brand of tree stand. You slide it in, click her back, simple as that. Now what you do is it's front pressure or weight, and these teeth will dig in and then you apply the pressure and it locks the stand in. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set it up on the tree and I'll show you just exactly how it works. I always like to set my upper section on first and then I raise it, get it out of the way so I'm not stumbling around the lower section. This is quite simple with the summit stand. You pull down, pop out, and it comes off. Set it up, wrap it around, back in the other side, and clip it in. Voila. Grab the lower section. Voila. Just like so. Now I'm ready to actually start climbing the tree. Once you have the cable around and it's back connected, this is what you do. You sit down on the top section. You always need your body weight or pressure at the front of the stand. You hook your feet into the stirrups. You go up, lock the teeth in, and sit down on the front. Bring the top up. Simple as that. It's a little tricky with once you're harnessed in, but you'll get used to it. So then it's just top, lock, bottom, lock, top, lock, bottom, lock. There you have it, everybody. Climb safe. Thanks for watching this week, Bonehead Tip of the Week.
Looking at me.
The Boneyard will be right back.
Killing Sticks. Premium carbon fiber arrows.
Welcome back to the Boneyard.
What can I say?
Failure.
There was like $7-$8 there. And more than half were shooters, but I, you know, crawled on my belly as far as I could. It was a young buck stayed back and watched me, and they came over the hill. I had them again at just a pretty extreme distance, but I've been shooting that about 70 some yards, and then they jumped the fence.
And the rest is history. It's now lunchtime, so we head back to Trevor and Ginger's place to regroup and to have a bite to eat. On the way back to town, Trevor makes a quick stop to show me some of his rams. Look at the horns on those sheep. Unbelievable. We're all fed up, so we head back out in search of a big old muley. Of course, we find some. Now all I need is a little luck.
Slowly I build this wall of mud.
So I'm crouched along a fence line in the tall grass. And those bucks are coming straight for me. As you can see, there's a bird hunter, and the bucks are fixated at this guy. And as that bird hunter keeps moving up the hill, he's pushing those bucks right towards me.
Man, they were gonna jump the fence and land right on top of me. I had to draw. What could I do? I came down a little too much because of the wind, eh? I thought I better scoot down a little more. Yeah, that 3-point was, he would have been really nice. 3 stalks this morning, 0 bucks, but I'm telling you, that was the closest yet. 22 yards. Yeah. Yeah, let's just, we'll sit and watch. Why don't you show them? They're standing out in the middle of the field. Well, there they go. But you know what? I don't think it's over. We're gonna let them bed down a little bit. And we'll see if I can get in close. But I'll tell you, man, they were coming on a string, like straight towards me. Not 2 feet to the left or to the right, but I mean straight for me. I had to draw.
They were 20 feet from the fence line. I'm in the deep grass, but you know what? That was awesome. It's been a great morning. That's my third stalk, and that was my closest one yet. You know, that 3 point's the biggest of the bunch, and he's tall and wide and heavy. It's not about the score on this guy, man. I just love him. So we'll try again.
Come on, guys. We know you can do it.
Okay, the big three turned around. All the other bucks are heading that way. He went down, and he bedded down in the hay bale stack there. So we're going to sneak around. I'm going to put an arrow in him. Down in this coulee. We don't know, he could be dead. We're gonna try to sneak up. We're coming from the opposite direction. The wind's in our favor. So join us. We're gonna go find him.
Yeah! Here we go. This is a Southern Alberta mule deer, man, at its best. This guy's like a 163 point. We were glassing the field. There was 18 muley bucks, and he was the granddad. He's an old boy. I can't be any happier down here with Trevor Timber and Tynes. Awesome. He's heavy. He's just beautiful, man. I am ecstatic. Woo! Boneyard, first kill of 2012. And you were there. Thank you, everybody. Yeah. I want to take this time to thank Trevor and Ginger Garbiar. It was one of my best hunts I've ever been on. Thanks, guys.
The Boneyard is brought to you by
Killing Sticks. Premium carbon fiber arrows.
If you're ever wondering what Jason and Calvin are doing day by day or minute to minute, go to their website, theboneyardtv.com.